So could you just start by introducing the sort of scale of the contract, your relationship with HCL?
Yeah. Okay. If you look at Aegon within the Aegon Netherlands, what we're talking about in the dealings with HCL, we mainly talk about application management. Mm-hmm. And roughly within Aegon as a whole, application management is somewhere in the range of, let me see, somewhere about 80 million euros. Mm-hmm. In that area, I think HCL is about one third from our the whole base. If you look at the number of hours involved, they are much bigger because we have our own Dutch providers, which work at higher rates, of course. So the number of work done by HCL is bigger, but the we call the share in terms of money-wise is lower.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So you have a multi-sourcing arrangement with some local suppliers.
Yeah. Actually, we're doing with the two suppliers. We have one local and one global supplier.
Okay. And so do you have like a primary supplier that then handles the relationships, or do you do all that internally?
No, we do that all internally. We select our own suppliers, and we said we don't want to have like a middleman. Mm-hmm. That's actually one of the essentials. We used to work with that that suppliers would then have a subcontractors, but we don't want to do that anymore. If it does add value for us, it's very difficult to pinpoint who is then responsible. Mm. So what we do is we want to have only their prime contractors. That's in our cases, that's Capgemini and HCL, and they do all the work. That's it.
Okay, and do you divide up the work based on expertise? So like best of breed in different areas?
No, what we do is the providers we selected are pretty top notch. So they're all capable of doing the whole broad range of work. So we manage them across domains. So for instance, we have in our back office systems, we have pensions and life and non-life systems, and those are, for instance, managed by HCL. Mm-hmm. And we have workforce management, which is managed by Capgemini, and front office, which is then a little bit of a mix of the two.
Okay. Yeah. And so you've gone through this process of selecting various partners, such as HCL, Capgemini. What advice would you give to someone else in your responsibility about selecting a good partner? Mm. What are the key attributes you look for?
I think the key attributes is looking into do we have a cultural fit with the organization? Mm-hmm. I think most of the suppliers are in the broad range in terms of rates have the same. If you say a lot of these providers are now doing quite well, whether they're in Indian, pure Indian players or more of a global player with different areas. Both models work out, so it's just what fits best with you. Mm. And then it all comes down to, I often compare it a little bit to a marriage. It's you maybe need to court each other a little bit to know what you're dealing with.
You still don't know that.
So you need to find out what really ticks the other person, and because then you know whether they're in sync with you. Mm. So it's very much tied to look very closely towards the culture, the relationship, what you were looking for. Do you want to approach it purely from the supplier point of view? You're probably looking towards a different a vendor than somebody you really want to partner with.
So it
pretty much boils down to looking at what kind of relationship do you want.
So if you're looking for a long-term partner, it can be quite subjective. It's who you feel comfortable with rather than who may be best in the metrics.
I think it is things like you don't have to go for the largest company. You don't want to maybe go for the smallest, but you want to have the partner who is has the best cultural fit, who has the same ideas of what you want to be.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much important. We've over the last 10 years, I've worked with a lot of vendors, and we have vendors who we selected, which after 1 year, you already know this is not going to work out. Because you don't have a fit. They, for instance, maybe look more towards a very process-oriented view, whereas myself, I would like to have more of a relationship point of view. And if they come up with waving with contracts, then you know you're on the wrong track.
And then, I mean, you mentioned about working with suppliers over 10 years. How have the suppliers changed in what they offer over that sort of decade?
I think the interesting thing, if we look at 10 years ago, we're only doing a small number of work in offshore kind of environment. And we had a pure Dutch player as our main supplier. I think the interesting thing that has changed is that after about 5 years, we're saying, look, we want to have a more of a global player kind of approach, and ask them to approach it from that side point of view, and we're not able to supply that. So then we shifted to a multi-vendor model, having a pure Indian player alongside the Dutch player. And what you now see is that these Dutch players are also keeping up, and they're now also becoming global players. So you see that the whole supplier is also changing, having more of a seeing that they can't keep on focusing just on being a Dutch player. It's not going to work out. So they you see them also moving more towards a mix.
Okay, and so you're based in the Netherlands, but we're here at the Gartner show in London. Do you see anything different in the industry? So the attitudes towards outsourcing or the maturity?
I would guess probably if we also talk to my UK colleagues, I think UK is probably further ahead in using offshore of partners. Benelux is at least a little bit hesitant still about moving offshore. I talk a lot in the Netherlands about offshoring, and I often say you need to start doing it. You need to find out yourself how it works out. You can't. You need to, if we call it in English, you need to find out yourself how it works. Where you still people see have cold feet of going into offshoring because they think language is going to be a problem, culture is going to be a problem, which are more, from my point of view, are more or less myths. You have the same problems with Dutch companies as you would have with Indian companies. You just needs to manage your relationship, whether it's an English company or a Dutch company or a Indian company, doesn't matter.
It's
just down to managing your relationship.
So many of the problems around cultural fit, it's more to do with business culture.
Do you want to really want to step into that kind of arena? You see people are want to hold on to what they have. You need to experience. There's a whole world out of them there of new possibilities, and then you need to do something about it.